Hi everyone, welcome back to all of you in my YouTube channel English with Dehati ma'am, and this is Yashoda. And friends, if you are new over here, so please make sure that you have subscribed to my channel and please press the bell icon so that you can easily get the notification when I will upload my videos. And friends, please stay in the video till the end so that which information I'm going to give you, you can use it in your English learning journey. Friends, as an English learner, or if you are the one who is thinking about learning this language, who is thinking about get fluency in that particular language, which is English language. So friends, I'm here to tell you that, friends, if you are a beginner, okay, you are on the initial stage of learning this language, so it's going to be very mashup. It's going to be create a mashup in your head that on which aspect I should focus on too much. I should focus on writing, I should focus on reading, I should focus on speaking, I should focus on listening. In YouTube, you will get so many videos, okay, and everyone is saying that you should focus on every and each aspect of learning this language. These four aspects are very important in order to learn English language, and these are reading, writing, listening and speaking. So in today's video, I'm going to tell you that how much you should focus on these aspects, which is very important for you. Is it writing, is it speaking, is it listening, or is it reading? Which one is very important for you? Friends, first of all, starts from the writing. Friends, writing is important. There's no doubt each and every aspect of learning English has its own importance. We can't deny this truth. So when it comes to writing, okay, when it comes to improve our writing skill in order to learn a language, so what is the use? What is the use of this aspect in our learning English journey? Friends, I tell you, okay, I am telling you, if you want to be perfect, if you want to be perfect in your writing skill as well as speaking skill, as well as you also want to improve your grammar, okay, so I think writing is going to be very helpful for you. We can't deny this truth. By writing, you can easily get the idea how to write a comprehension, okay, how to write a letter, how can we use writing skill, okay, in our studies, okay. If you want to learn this skill, then you can easily improve, okay, then you can easily improve your writing skill, okay, in order to clear an exam, in order to know the perfect grammar rule, writing skill is going to be very helpful for you, okay. And next, now it comes to reading. How much reading is very helpful for you? You should focus on reading or not? Then my answer is, you should focus on reading, because reading helps you to enhance your vocab as well as your pronunciation, as well as you can easily get the idea how to use the structures in our speaking. You can easily get the important structures that we need to in order to speak, and you can also be habitual to English, to speak English. Because friend, when we read any book, any sort of book aloud, okay, we read aloud, okay, then it's going to help, okay, it's going to help us to make our tongue, to make our jaw muscles habitual to this particular language, to this English language or any language, what kind of language you want to learn, okay. And we know that we need so much vocab in order to speak best English, so that we don't fumble while speaking. So in order to this, Okay, in order to this, that we don't fumble, we need much vocab. Because without lagging of vocabs, it comes a point when we fumble a lot because we don't have enough vocab. So how can we easily learn new vocabs? Only by reading. So that reading is very important. Okay, we can't deny all this truth that each and every aspect has its own importance. Friends, now it comes to listening. Listening plays a very important role in order to speak fluent English. We can easily get pronunciation of each and every word, and we can easily get the idea how to speak English. If we know the writing skill, if you know about grammar or not, it doesn't matter. Okay, whether you know about grammar rules or not. But if you are the one who is illiterate, okay, who is illiterate and who don't know anything about English, but if you keep listening a lot, okay, in your whole day you listen only this language, okay, this particular language, which language you want to learn, then definitely you don't need any grammar, okay, you don't need anything, and you can be a fluent English speaker. Because listening helps us to create that environment. And we know that the environment, English environment, is very important. It's going to be very helpful for you, that environment, which we are creating by listening a lot. So, please make sure that you should listen a lot. You should listen a lot in order to be a fluent English speaker. If you want to learn this language, if you want to be fluent, okay, in this particular language, so you should focus on listening a lot. And in the last, it's speaking. Friends, we know that we want to be fluent in English, okay, we have a dream to speak fluent English, we want to speak English like a native speaker. So if you want to be a fluent English speaker, so we can't keep this aspect aside. Even this thing, this aspect is very important. Only this aspect is going to help you to be a fluent English speaker. If you are the one who is not doing your English speaking practice, you are doing your reading, writing, listening practice, but you have a fear of speaking in front of anyone, and because of this you are not going ahead. Okay, you are not going to get your opportunities. You are not going to grab your opportunities when you get any opportunities to speak in front of anyone. Because of that fear, you are not speaking, then you are not going to be a fluent English speaker. There is no doubt. Because friend, what is your goal? What is your last goal? You just want to speak fluent English. So you should focus on speaking too much. And in this way, you are definitely going to be a fluent English speaker. Okay. So definitely this video is going to help you a lot. And we will meet again in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.